This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Chimney sweep's cancer, also called soot wart, is a squamous cell carcinoma of the skin of the scrotum. It has the distinction of being the first reported form of occupational cancer, and was initially identified by Percival Pott in 1775. It was initially noticed as being prevalent amongst chimney sweeps. Contents 1. Pathogenesis 2. History 21. Social context 22. Sir Percival Pott 23. Treatment 3. Related diseases 4. See also 5. References 6. External links. Pathogenesis chimney sweeps carcinoma is a squamous cell carcinoma of the skin of the scrotum. Warts caused by the irritation from soot particles, if not excised, developed into a scrotal cancer. This then invaded the dartos, enlarged the testicle, and proceeded up the spermatic cord into the abdomen, where it proved fatal. History chimney sweeps carcinoma was first detected in 1775. The cancer primarily affected chimney sweeps in their late teens and early 20s who had been in contact with soot since their early childhood. It was proposed that sweat running down their bodies had caused soot to accumulate in the rugae of the inferior surfaces of the scrotum. Irritation was later discounted as the cause when it was experimentally shown in 1922 that an ingredient of coal soot was a carcinogen. Social context: the disease was principally a British phenomenon. In Germany, for example, sweeps wore tight-fitting protective clothing which prevented the soot from accumulating on the lower surface of the scrotum, whereas boys in the UK were once sent up the chimneys wearing only trousers and shirt, and occasionally naked in the United Kingdom before the flexible brush was introduced. The master sweeps took apprentices, who were boys from the workhouse or bought them from their parents, and trained them to climb chimneys in the German states. Master sweeps belonged to trade guilds and did not use climbing boys. In Italy, Belgium, and France, climbing boys were used. Boys as young as 4 climbed hot flues that could be as narrow as 9. Burned to death, the boys slept under the soot sacks and were rarely washed. From 1775 onwards, there was increasing concern for the welfare of the boys, and Acts of Parliament were passed to restrict, and in 1875 to stop this usage. Lord Shaftesbury, the philanthropist, led the later campaign in the United States. Black children were hired from their owners and used in the same way, and were still climbing after 1875. Sir Percival Pott. Sir Percival Pott, 6 January 1714 to the 22nd of December 1788, London, England, was an English surgeon, one of the founders of orthopedy, and the first scientist to demonstrate that a cancer may be caused by an environmental carcinogen. In 1765, he was elected Master of the Company of Surgeons, the forerunner of the Royal College of Surgeons. It was in 1775 that Pott found an association between exposure to soot and a high incidence of chimney sweeps carcinoma, a scrotal cancer later found to be squamous cell carcinoma in chimney sweeps. This was the first occupational link to cancer, and Pott was the first person to demonstrate that a malignancy could be caused by an environmental carcinogen. Pott's early investigations contributed to the science of epidemiology and the Chimney Sweepers Act 1788. Pott describes chimney sweeps carcinoma thus: it is a disease which always makes its first attack on the inferior part of the scrotum, where it produces a superficial, painful, ragged, ill-looking sore with hard rising edges and no great length of time. It pervades the skin, dartos, and the membranes of the scrotum, and seizes the testicle, which it enlargesic, hardens, and renders truly and thoroughly distempered, whence it makes its way up the spermatic process into the abdomen. He comments on the life of the boys. The fate of these people seems peculiarly hard. They are treated with great brutality. They are thrust up narrow and sometimes hot chimneys, where they are bruised, burned, and almost suffocated, and when they get to puberty, they become liable to a most noisome, painful, and fatal disease. The carcinogen was thought to be coal tar, possibly containing some arsenic, though Pott wrote no further papers on the subject. Clinical reports began to appear suggesting that others had seen it without realizing what it was, and like Pott had said, it is generally taken, both by patient and surgeon, for venereal and treated with mercurial. The disease was usually preceded by the development of hyperkeratotic lesions on the scrotum, which was what the sweeps called soot warts. These could be benign. Sweeps often removed them themselves by trapping them in a split cane and cutting them off with a pocket knife. For instance, he seized with a split stick and cut off with a razor. He remarked that it was not very painful. He resumed work the following day. but if the lesion had become malignant, it was far more serious. Patients frequently delayed seeking medical opinion, and when they did, many were in a dreadful state. A 28-year-old sweep approached Jefferies in 1825, who describes his condition: "The sore occupies the whole of the left side of the scrotum and the inner angle of the thigh, extending from the anus to the posterior inferior spinous process of the ileum, presenting a surface as large as a man's open hand, with hard indurated edges and irregular margins, discharging a thin sanies, which is extremely offensive. The left testicle is entirely denuded, and projects from its center, in the left groin is a mass of indurated glands, the size of a goose's egg, which appears to suppurate in the right groin. There is likewise an ulceration, of the same malignant nature, about the size of a half crown 5 centimeters. Despite the appearance of this growth, the unfortunate man was in no pain, and his only complaint was that about 10 days before his admission he had bled from his groin and lost about a pint of blood. Even this, however, had not unduly affected his constitution. Treatment was by surgery, where all the diseased flesh was cut out before the introduction of anesthetics. This was a simple process for the surgeon but terrifying for the patient. Alternative treatments were also proposed, including the application of an arsenic paste. Poultice. The real cause of this cancer was unproved until the discovery of weak carcinogens in soot by Pasley in 1922. Until then, the most popular theory was that soot got trapped in the rugae of the scrotum, and this caused a general irritation. Sweeps were not known for their attention to bodily hygiene, and it was assumed they never washed their genitals. The youngest victim, recorded in 1790 by James Earl Pott's son-in-law, was 8 years old. Related diseases. Decades later, it was noticed to occur amongst gas plant and oil shale workers, and it was later found that certain constituents of tar, soot, and oils, known as polycyclic aromatic hydrocarbons, were found to cause cancer in laboratory animals. The related cancer, mule spinner's carcinoma, was blamed on the carcinogenic content of shale oil that was used to lubricate the rapidly revolving mule spindles. See also mule spinner's cancer. References. Notes. General Surgery Lecture Notes. Hellis, Wiley Blackwell, 12th edition. ABCD. Waldron, 1983. P. ISBN